Hello everyone, I'm Tom Grinsted. I'm Group Product Manager for Mobile and Devices at The Guardian. I'm also really, really aware that I'm the final lightning talk of the final session of the day, so I'm going to make it as lightning as possible because, you know, drinks. So I'm really going to talk about how we've tried, especially in the apps team over the last year, to introduce some new ways of working to really unlock the creativity that's embedded in development teams themselves. It's taken quite a long time for the industry in general, and to be frank, the publishing industry specifically, to understand that development is a creative process in and of itself, and teams of developers and designers have really creative ideas, and the task for us is to really try to unlock them. Now, there are loads of different ways to try to unlock ideas and to try to get features out to the public, and there are loads of different ways to plot them as well. But for the sake of this talk, I'm going to plot them along two different axes. So along the x-axis, then you've got kind of self-led creativity, ideas that you come up on your own, yourself, and you try to make happen. And at the other end, you've got imposed creativity, stuff that's given to you by other people. And then along the y-axis, we've got business return, right? So you've got features that, when they're eventually deployed, give really, really high value to the business and high value to your users. And it's worth kind of saying those two things are essentially synonymous. And you've got things that are low value, so either that nobody uses or that don't help the business at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look up at a few different ways that we work and how they plot along these two different axes. So what would be a good example of the top right? Well, strategic features, right? If they're strategic features, they might be very, very high value because it's aligning to the entire strategy of your business. And they're also likely to be imposed, because the business is saying, team, I really need you to do this. In our case, it might be, team, I really need you to get many, many more users signed into the app. Then you've got things like backlogs. Now, I'd argue that backlogs, they tend towards being slightly more self-creative, because developers, especially in functioning agile teams, can go and pick up cards that they think are really important. But they are also tend towards being, or they do tend towards being imposed, right? People like me help kind of shape backlogs. Then you've got bad ideas. Bad ideas, they tend towards being, well, especially bad ideas from senior management. I'm admitting to this. imposed creativity and low value. We really need to do this, team. Crap, it's failed. Then you've got bugs and debt. Now, I was trying to decide where to put this, right? So our teams at The Guardian are really enabled to genuinely care about the quality of their products. And they pick up individual bugs, individual pieces of debt, as and when they think it's really, really important. Now, individually, they tend towards being low value. Although I don't want you guys to think I'm not saying that quality is important. Quite the opposite, quality is critical. Taken together, they might be all the way up there. But if you look at them on an individual basis, they're comparatively low quality, but they're slightly more self-led. Now, the next one we're going to look at is hack days. Can you put your hands up if you know what a hack day is? Okay, so not huge numbers. Can you put your hand up if you've participated in a hack day? Okay, roughly the same number of numbers. A hack day is where you get loads and loads of developers into a room together, and you say, go away and build something and demo it at the end. So it's kind of, in some ways, the purest example of self-led creativity. Now, sometimes hack day projects are hugely valuable. In fact, The Guardian has an internal suite of analytics called OFAN, which is phenomenal. It's fantastic. That grew out of one of our hack days. But very often, so it's worth saying that would be all the way up here. But very often, hack day projects don't align to the strategic aims because they're really an opportunity for developers to go away and play. Sometimes they're an amazing idea, but they don't have enough resource behind them and they can't do because of other things the business are doing. Sometimes, frankly, they're just playing to the crowd. So sometimes hack day ideas are very, very high value. But very often than not, hack days have a low hit rate for long-term value to the business. Now, by this way, I'm talking about feature-specific. There are loads of other really, really good reasons to do hack days. Giving your developers a chance to work together. It's a fantastic tool to get people who never talk to each other actually talking. But if you're being brutal about just single features, hack days in and of themselves aren't long enough and aren't focused enough to deliver consistent return for the business. OFAN. So for me, the key question is, what can fit here? Can you construct a way of working which is both very high value, unleashes the creativity of your development teams, and has a really good return for the business. And for us, the thing that fits in that question mark is the build week. Now, the build week, as you might guess, is a bit like a hack day. But instead of just hacking something together as quickly as you can just to demo it to an audience, you build it, and you build it to a point where it's in principle testable. Instead of being a day, it's a week. And the reason it's a week is that gives our development teams and our engineers and our UX designers enough time to actually build something which is really, really compelling. But like a hack day, it unleashes their creativity by giving a huge amount of self-led of self-awareness, so they really get to choose what they're going to build. And there are a few rules to it. The first, and this is important to unleashing the strategic value, is there's a strategic theme. So ones that we've run over the last year have been around mobile monetization, around editorial innovation, around key personalization, and about making our apps quicker and more responsive. Solutions aren't imposed. The job of someone like me is to simply give the theme and then allow the teams, as large as they can be, to get on and come up with the most creative ideas they can on their own to try to meet that theme. We take time at the beginning of the project to the build week to deeply understand what we're trying to do. And critically, the output is testable. This needs to be able to go somewhere where we get actual feedback from actual users. So this is an example of one of the hack weeks we ran recently. This is my lovely team working on it. It's worth pointing out that the team isn't just engineers. You've got Frank there, he's a designer. You've got Shubhjit, he's our mobile editor. You've got Helen up there, who's a UX researcher. For our hack weeks, we try to make a team which is as broad as possible. Now, I said that one of the key things is the output is testable, and I wanted to kind of dwell a little bit on what I meant there. Because the idea of the build week is you're coming up with tangible, useful things for users. So what do I mean by testable? Well, at one end, you've got testing in our UX lab. Now, that's great, but really what we're looking for a build week is something which can be tested slightly further afield. Then we've got our alpha program. Now, we use the alpha program on Google Play to do nightly builds of our Android app that go out to any of the internal users within The Guardian. And the alpha program is a fantastic way, at the end of a build week, to test stability across 600 users. It's also great to get stakeholders really excited. There's nothing like somebody suddenly seeing a feature they didn't know existed for the first time that really answers one of their needs to get it rapidly into production. We also use our beta program, and if you're interested in signing up to the beta program, you can follow that URL at the top. Our beta program runs at thousands of Android users, and we often take some of the fantastic ideas that come out of our build weeks and whack them straight into beta. Or we also do stage rollout MVT and A/B testing in our live environment as well. But the key point is we're asking the teams to spend 1 week deeply understanding a problem and coming up with the most creative ideas they can to solve that, and then proving if their ideas work or not. And on such a provable, is this provably successful? Do I have concrete examples where this has worked? It's quite telling that when I was putting these slides together, one of the contacts in Google kind of contacted me and went, shouldn't this be probably? And I was like, no, this is provably, it's demonstrable. So what are a few examples, just to wrap up, where the build weeks have really helped The Guardian? Well, the first one is our hide ads button. So if you look at the advertisement on the right-hand side there, there's a lovely little hide button. This grew out of our mobile monetization week, and it drives users to our ad-free premium subscription. Now, one of the developers came up with this. It seems like an obvious idea, but because of completely understandable internal debate within The Guardian, we'd never got to the stage where we are actually rolling this feature out, because ads and subs are, in our app, mutually incompatible, and they're two different revenue streams. Having this already built as part of the build week allowed us to test it really, really rapidly and come to the discussions about whether it was a good idea with real statistically relevant data to inform the decision. As you can guess, if any of you use the Android app, that decision was to deploy it to live, because we did. And it delivered a huge increase in subs conversion rates. Search and profile. It was a bugbear for personalization that all of your read history wasn't available. And one of our developers built this lovely kind of set of profile and search. This went straight into the UX labs, and it was loved so much we deployed it to live within, I think, 3 weeks. It's another kind of wonderful example which showed real benefits for users who are looking to go back over articles that they've read before. So what's coming up? At our personalization build week, then one of the developers got together with one of our server-side developers and built a new recommendation engine, which we're probably going to call Discover. This isn't live yet, but it's probably coming out this quarter. It's the kind of investment the business as a whole probably wouldn't have made if it had been asked to strategically decide what it was going to do initially. But because it was kickstarted by the build week, it's allowed us to really, really rapidly take it into the alpha program. Similarly, Read It To Me. Read It To Me uses text-to-speech engine in Android to allow you to consume any piece of Guardian content without a screen. What's really nice is, as of the build week last week, it not only works on your phone, but also interfaces with Wear, and now interfaces with Auto as well. Now, this is another one where the Guardian as a whole probably wouldn't have spontaneously come up with this, because we're so concentrated on the written word, which is completely understandable. But by putting editorial innovation, which was the theme of the build week, to our engineers, we came up with a feature that we really, really hope is going to substantially increase engagement. And it makes us happy. These are my happy team. So what's the takeaway that I'm really suggesting to you here? Now, those of you who run Hack Weeks, they're fantastic. Those of you who run very, very top-down development, that's sometimes required and needed. But there is a fantastic middle ground. That fantastic middle ground is well describing the problem and allowing your teams to go away and engineer their solutions and then test them. So if you don't take anything else away from this, just try that out at least once and see what you get, because you hopefully will be pleasantly surprised. Thanks very much.